गुड आफ्टरनून फ्रेंड्स. सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट द न्यू टॉपिक. ओके, सो दैट इज द यूनिट नंबर 3 एंड इट्स यू आर अल्ट्रासोनिक. ओके, सो इन दिस यूनिट वी विल लर्न अबाउट व्हाट इज अल्ट्रासोनिक वेव्स, हाउ दिस वेव्स कैन बी जनरेटेड. ओके, एंड हाउ टू डिटेक्ट द अल्ट्रासोनिक वेव्स एज वेल एज what are the properties of the ultrasonic waves which can be used in a medical application and other industrial application also. That we are going to learn in this unit. So first unit maximum portion we have completed and sound portion is remain. Sound portion and second unit that will cover after this, and in sequence of that modes of vibration and waves will go for this ultrasonic wave. Okay, so first upon we'll learn what is ultrasonic wave. Okay, so ultrasonic wave means the wave which having the frequency greater than 20 kilohertz. Okay, so generally what happens, so human ears are audible to the frequency range of 20 hertz to 20 kilohertz. That means we can hear the frequency range from 20 hertz to 20 kilohertz. That is known as your sound waves. So if any sound is produced, I am speaking that is your sound is produced, but that sound having frequency ranges from 20 hertz to 20 kilohertz. So that is your audible sound. Okay, if the frequency of the sound is less than 20 hertz, that is inaudible to the human ear. So that waves is known as your infrasonic waves. Okay, and if the sound wave which having the frequency greater than 20 kilohertz means greater than human audible range. What is the human audible range? 20 hertz to 20 kilohertz. And if sound is produced more than 20 kilohertz frequency range, then that sound wave is known as your ultrasonic wave. Okay, so this ultrasonic waves we have going to learn means these waves will produce having frequency greater than 20 kilohertz. So that's why you can define the ultrasonic wave as the wave having frequency greater than 20 kilohertz. If the frequency is greater than 20 kilohertz, then it is known as your which waves? Ultrasonic waves. Or you can say that in another language, the wave having frequency greater than human audible limit. What is the human audible limit? 20 hertz to 20 kilohertz. If the frequency is greater than 20 kilohertz, then that is known as your ultrasonic wave. So in next lecture, in this slide we are going to learn what are the properties of the ultrasonic wave. So first is that ultrasonic waves are very high in frequency. Actually there is a frequency term is there here, it is not here, it is given. Okay, the frequency of, what is the property? The frequency of ultrasonic wave is very high. So ultrasonic waves having frequency 20 kilohertz are greater than that. That is up to 500 kilohertz also. Okay, so that is the very high frequency range. So if the frequency is high, its wavelength will low, because frequency and wavelength both are inversely proportional. What is the formula for frequency and that is his pain here. So mu is equals to, if this is your mu is your frequency, or you can take n is also. Okay, so mu is equals to velocity divided by there is a wavelength is denoted by lambda. So if this you have to use here, so mu is, this mu means frequency, velocity by wavelength. If this frequency is high, this wavelength will be low, because both are inversely proportional. Okay, so the frequency of ultrasonic waves are very high, that's why they have very low wavelength, and they have very low wavelengths, and this property is used in a penetration power. Ultrasonic wave have very small wavelength, so they have the very high penetration power. Okay, and they can penetrate through the small region also, because its wavelength is small, and due to the smaller wavelength they also show the negligible diffraction. What is diffraction? Diffraction means when there are the obstacles, the beams are bent from that obstacle, but if the wavelength is small, the wave will easily pass through the obstacle. That's why they show the negligible diffraction, as well as ultrasonic waves are move faster in a denser material. That means if you take the speed of a ultrasonic wave in case of air, okay, it is 300 meter per second. If it is in case of this soft tissue, it is 1500 meter per second. And if you take for the bones, it is 3000 meter per second. So as the density of the material is increases, the velocity of the ultrasonic wave is also increases. Now, that is the ultrasonic, that property is ultrasonic waves travel faster in the dense material. So another property is like ordinary sound wave, ultrasonic waves get reflected, refracted and absorbed. So it shows the properties of ordinary wave. Ordinary wave means the wave will get, suppose this is known as your reflection. So ultrasonic waves also shows the phenomena of reflection that is used in sonar, sound navigation and here it is application sonar. Sound navigation and ranging, it is used for measuring the depth of the sea. Okay, at that time the wave is get reflected from the bottom of the sea. Okay, so it shows the phenomena of reflection as well as it shows the phenomena of refraction that we will be going to learn in the acoustic grading. Okay, as well as some wavelength are waves are absorbed by this material also. So it shows the general phenomena of wave, that is reflection, reflection and reflection, refraction and absorption. Okay, and these are the two applications of the ultrasonic waves. So you can construct a grating when ultrasonic waves are confined in a particular liquid, and in that region we have to produce the ultra stationary waves. If you produce the stationary wave in that liquid, okay, this waves will act, there will be production of nodes and antinodes. So this nodes and antinodes region will be act as a diffraction grating. Similarly, ultrasonic waves are used in industrial application as well as medical application. You know the sonography, that is the ultrasonic waves are used in sonography. So it is the medical application of ultrasonic wave, as well as ultrasonic waves are used to measure the depth of the sea. That means if you see if ship is there, ship agar jahaj pani ke upar hai, so what happens, it will produce the waves from its bottom, and wave from the bottom surface the waves will get reflected in upward direction. So you can determine the depth of the sea by using this sonar. So these are the properties of your ultrasonic waves. Okay, next is how ultrasonic waves can be generated. So ultrasonic waves can be generated by two methods. First is your piezoelectric generator method and second is your magnetostriction generator method. Okay, so what is piezoelectric? In piezoelectric effect, if you apply the, suppose this is the crystal, if you apply the pressure on this side, they on the perpendicular to this side, there is a production of electric charge. Okay, or if you apply the electric charge here, there is a production of mechanical stress. So this property is known as your piezoelectric. Here you have to apply the electric charge on one two opposite faces, and perpendicular to these faces there is a production of stress. Okay, or if you apply the stress on these two faces, on this side there is a production of electric charge. So that is known as your piezoelectric generator. Now next is your magnetostriction generator. So in case of magnetostriction generator, what happens, if a ferromagnetic rod is there and that rod is get magnetized and demagnetized, okay, what happens, it length will get changed. If you magnetize the ferromagnetic matter, its length, there is slight change in its length, it will get expelled. Again, if you demagnetize, it will get compressed. So in this way it will get compressed and expelled, it will generate the frequency. Okay, similar here also, if you apply the mechanical pressure, it will generate the electric charge, or inverse piezoelectric means if you apply the electric field on one side, it will be compressed and expelled on another side, and it will generate the frequency. So these two are the, this is by using magnetic effect, this is by using electric charge effect. So that is piezoelectric generator and this is the magnetostriction generator. So this is your generation of the ultrasonic waves. So this is your piezoelectric generator and this is your magnetostriction generator. Okay, so this is about your ultrasonic waves. So what you have learned is, what is ultrasonic waves? Which having the frequency greater than the human audible range, that is greater than 20 kilohertz. And these are the properties of the ultrasonic wave, having very high frequency, low wavelength, and it has the due to its low wavelength, it will get have the high penetration power, high energy and low diffraction, and it is behave as an ordinary wave. And in this two way, piezoelectric generator and magnetostriction generator, you can generate this ultrasonic waves. And next lecture we are going to learn about the piezo, how exactly we have to generate the ultrasonic wave by using piezoelectric generator. Okay, so thank you, here we stop now. And